What's your name?
Beatrice.
Beatrice. Okay. What's the name of your father, Beatrice?
Kisilo.
Kisilo. Okay. Family name, please.
Zilani.
Zilani. Your nationality is?
Kenya.
Kenya. Okay. Are you Christian or Muslim?
Christian.
Christian. Did you go to university or whatever? School?
High school.
High school. Are you sick or pregnant or whatever? Or no?
No.
You are
no.
Not? Okay. What you want to do? To be here in Lebanon or to work again or go?
No, I want to travel back home.
You want to travel back home.
Beatrice Zilani Kisilu, aka Betty Georgina, from Kenya, Nairobi, and I'm 19 years old, and I'm the last born in our family. I came to Lebanon the 4th of July 2014. I was coming to work because I need money to support myself. But my agent lied to me because she had told me that I'm coming to work in the house, but 5 days per week, 7 hours per day. But when I came to work, it was different from the way she told me, because I was taking care of a paralyzed man, and it was not easy for me to change diapers and stuff. So she took me to the agent here in Beirut. She took my mobile phone and she told me, you're going to stay here for 1 week and I'll change you the house because you have to work. If you don't want to work, you must pay me $3,000 for you to be able to travel back home. So in that 1 week, I was sleeping in the garage, I think, because there's so much cars, and in the office. There's no food, there's no taking shower, there's nothing. So within, after that 1 week, I was taken to another house in Beka, Baalbek. In that house, the madam, she's ever shouting, and she treats you like a dog. Yani, you're not a human being. You have to sleep in the kitchen, in the floor. You have to eat leftovers. Yani, you have to wake up at 6, sometimes 5, because of the kids are going to school. You have to sleep late night. She doesn't care about you. Like, even if you are sick, she doesn't care. You have to work because you came here to work. So I tried my best, but unfortunately, I did not make it up to the end of the contract. My employer came from Kuwait. My boss, that is, so after when he came, he had not paid me for 6 months. So I told him that I want to send my salary back home because now I was planning to run away.
اسمي إليان، مساعدة اجتماعية بكاريتاس مركز الإيواء. المركز بلش بال 2007. أول ما بلشنا كانت الفكرة من بعد حرب تموز، لأنه صار عنا كثير طلبات لبنات أجانب كانوا يشتغلوا بلبنان، كفالاءهم تركوهم بالبيوت، وكنا عم نستقبل كل يوم حوالي 100 بنت أجنبية عاملة أجنبية بهيدا المركز هون. من بعد ما خلصت الحرب كمان لقينا أنه في حاجة لبيت أمان يقدر يستقبل كل الحالات وكل الأشخاص يلي عندهم أمراض مزمنة أو بحاجة لمتابعة نفسية أو اجتماعية أو حتى طبية.
Happy birthday! Happy birthday! Happy birthday!
نحن هون بالشلتر نستقبل عدد ايام كثير كبير عن الاعداد الموجوده اللي نحن نقدر نستقبلها، فهالشيء بخلينا نضطر ايام نكون بحاجه لفرشات زياده، حرامات زياده، عم نضطر نحط بنتين بكل تخت. بس نحن كمان ما فينا نرفض هالشخص لما بيدق باب الكاريتاس نقول له نحن ما بنستقبلك، هالشيء كمان عم بيسبب عبء وتقل شوي كمان على المطبخ اللي هو كمان المطبخ بحاجه لاعاده تاهيل، لانه لما بنزيد بنت من هون على التخت يعني كمان المطبخ بده يزيد صحن اكل زياده اضافي.
اسمي وبيت زلاقة، بشتغل بكاريتاس بالمطبخ، مسؤولة المطبخ صار لي 4 سنين هون. كانت الأسس الجديد وهيك، بس لأنه في الشام مش عم بيتغيروا، بس الضروريات على مثلا مثل الصحن مثل الكباية وهيك أكيد ما الضروريات بيجيبوا لنا، يعني في أشياء يعني مثلا هلا مثل هيدا الجرور إذا بفتحه بتتضحك يعني. في كتير أشياء ناقصنا، في يعني لازم نغيره يعني، يعني ضروريات ايه مثلا مثل شفتي اللي انا فيه كيف بتعذبنا وكيف نتعذب من تحت المجلن، مثل شفتيها عم تنزل المي لهيدا الكمين كل دقيقه لازم نشطفها، كل دقيقه لازم نكبل المي، ولهيدا غير الشغل الاكل والزيد الشغل البماط.
I communicated with my friends in Kenya and she was able to send me $100 to be able to escape from Baker to Beirut because it's like 4 hours maximum. So she sent me $100 to the Syrian man because I don't have passport. I cannot withdraw the cash to the Syrian man. Then he withdrew the money for me. Then I just woke up and took my mobile phone and my shoes and opened the door slowly, and I ran away. So I took taxi to the embassy. When I reached to the embassy, it was like about 8:30, so they had not yet opened. So they told me to wait about maybe 30 minutes, Mr. Joseph, the consulate will be there. So I waited for him and he came. Then I asked me to give him my employer's number and agent number. The agent said that I don't remember sending such a girl to Lebanon. So he called my employer now. My employer said I've stolen $1,500 from him. So the consulate started shouting to me, "You have stolen, you are a thief. What will I do with you? You are a thief." He started shouting to me, told him, "I did not steal anything. I don't have any money." The consulate told me, "I will take you to a place. You'll go and stay there maybe for 2 weeks. And you'll meet a lawyer. He will investigate you if she he or she finds you that you are guilty, you will be taken to jail. If you are innocent, they will pay your ticket and your salary and you will travel back home. The embassy came today and told me I'm traveling on Monday. Alhamdulillah.